Hi, I'll be making atta bhakarwari today. It's a very popular snack. To start with, I'll roast a few dhania seeds and sauf. 2 teaspoon dhania seeds, 1 teaspoon sauf. You have to roast it well. Whenever you're grinding whole spices, you should always roast them before grinding because it adds to the flavor of the spices. I can smell the dhania and sauf together and already feel what the bhakarwari will taste like. I'll put it in a jar for grinding. To this, I'll be adding 2 tablespoons boiled sabut moong, about a teaspoon of gur, some green chilies, salt to taste, fresh coriander leaves, and fresh mint leaves. We just have to grind it. Let's check it if it's done. Everything's ground well. I just take it out in a bowl. Now the mixture is ready. So we'll start preparing the bhakarwari. Before that, I'll heat a kadai and pour oil enough for deep frying. While the oil is getting hot, I'll prepare the rolls. That we need atta, which I've already made a dough of. Using salt and 2 teaspoons of hot oil. Take a little flour or atta to dust and just roll out. Now on this, I'll spread this mixture. Spread it evenly. Just leave out a little on the sides for sticking. And now we have to roll it up. To seal the edges, just apply a little water and seal the edges. And now cut approximately 1-inch pieces. You can shape them a little better after cutting them. Now the oil is hot, so I'll be frying them. We have to fry them till they are crisp and golden brown. Now they are golden brown, so I'll be taking them out. Drain out as much oil as you can. I'll be serving it with some tomato ketchup. Bhakarwari can be stored in an airtight container for about 3 to 4 days, so you can enjoy them not just for one day but for lots of days. So here you go, atta bhakarwari is ready to serve.